Well, Orica Green Edge really set up the win by being clever enough to have Simon Clark up the road, as we said, and that effectively meant the team could relax and get ready for crunch time.
Absolutely. I think their intention was to be relaxed. I don't think they necessarily wanted him to try and aim for jersey points, but he was obviously feeling good, and so that was an opportunistic move by Simon. Yeah. It was really impressive. But obviously, when things came back together just before that final climb, we had about 13 kilometres to go. And what we can see now is the extraordinary work here by dual points world champion and Madison world champion Cam Meyer. He's got that red face going that he gets when he's working really hard. Here there's now Clark, Albasini and Meyer. Clark's been in the break all day, still working quite relentlessly.
Still riding at 3.5K.
Yeah, absolutely. And this is my most favoured part. You can see Daryl Impey cutting along the inside of this corner on the right-hand side. Oh. Sagan immediately jumps over onto his wheel, and you can see Rojas and Gilbert are sort of there loitering at the back, but Impey gives him this fantastic lead-out. And Gero goes with about 75 or so metres to go with Sagan on his wheel, and we all know how fast Peter Sagan is. And it was certainly very close, and their bike throws were pretty classy. Sagan's actually wasn't quite as good as Gero's, in a little bit of skew
early,
if there.
Yeah. It's too early.
But it was still a little bit hard to call in those early seconds. It was just such an impressive team effort. You know, we saw the work of Clark and the other riders.
Oh, it was absolutely perfect. There's nothing else they could have done. I mean, Daryl Impey was so cool the way he waited and waited until Cannondale ran out of riders in front of Sagan, and then he went and he was still going at 150. Gero only sprinted 150, but it was amazing.
Well, we've talked about amazing last lead out guys. We know Mark Renshaw is very good at it and Greg Henderson's very good at it, but this is something we haven't necessarily seen before. Actually, in the Tour of California, we saw Baden Cook leading out Michael Matthews, the under 23 world champion, looking over his shoulder the whole time, like, are you still there? Are you still there? So it's really fantastic to see this work so well.
How do we put this win into perspective? I mean, the big boys all came out to play today and threw everything to get this stage win, didn't they?
Well, what was great, when Matt White said, you know, Gero's not a very big guy, but he's very fast, I think it is pretty ambitious that he would have won this in a bunch kick. It wasn't some solo break or a Milan-San Remo, you know, sprint of nine guys. So it's really quite momentous, yeah.
I mean, it was still a difficult stage too, but where Orica Green Edge were good is they had the numbers in the end. You know, they still had five guys helping Gero in the final kilometres, and no other team had it. That's why they were simply so strong as a group.
Sure, and as you know, when you're really committed to someone, and I've done this in a team, I'm sure you have, when you've got a rider that you know and believe in, you are actually able to give everything that is required, and you're not really thinking about how you're feeling, you're just thinking about achieving the objective and going through that process, and you could see that on their faces.
Exactly. And you know where from here, like they've had yesterday, the plan went perfectly, but today they can win the yellow jersey.
Yeah.
They're in within a millimetre of the jersey. So again, the pressure's on.
Well, look, what I've got from you guys over the last couple of days is this undercurrent that pressure is really building up within the team. Does that just take the top off now and they can relax, or and where is this pressure coming from?
Well, we know that Gerry Ryan set up this team, you know, to help facilitate a greater development of cycling in Australia. But he also, selfishly, which is understandable, it's his millions of dollars, he wants to be on the Champs-Élysées with a winning team. And he picked fantastic staff, and they very carefully selected a roster that they felt would be worthy of that. So there's pressure, of course, and from sponsors. And,
oh, you know, exactly. But the team's so young. This is their second year.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, the team's in its early stages, and progressively as they get further, then they can start looking for a GC rider or develop the young talent that we've got now. You know, the Cameron Myers, they're already showing they're capable of riding these big tours.
Yeah.
So they've just got to keep going the way they are.
Exciting stuff. Thanks, guys. Thank you, Dr. Bridie, for your dissection there. Great stuff.